Welcome. We'll focus today on regions where two adjacent tectonic plates move towards each other. These are convergent or active margins. A well-known example is between the South American and the Nazca plates. The first is continental and therefore light. The second is oceanic and thus heavy. In these cases, the oceanic plate descends underneath the continental plate. These are subduction zones. Convergence can take place at rates larger than 10 centimeters per year and has been going on for millions of years. You can imagine that a lot of interaction must have taken place between these plates. It is not a surprise that convergence zones are also called active continental margins. There are three major types of phenomena taking place at active continental margins: volcanism, earthquakes, and crustal accretion. Volcanism is one of the most apparent features of subduction zones. Volcanoes are found all along Arctic continental margins and are always located on the upper plate of the subduction zone, tens of kilometers away from the convergence zones. What are the processes linking volcanism to active margin? This has to do with the relations between melting point and magmatism we have discussed in a previous clip. During its downward movement, the subducting plate brings fluids contained in sedimentary rocks down to large depths. With increasing load of the overlying rocks, the fluids will be squeezed out of the rock, will migrate upward, and will lower the melting point of the overlying upper plate rocks. These will then melt and generate magmas which will rise and form intrusive and extrusive rocks. Earthquakes are a constant feature of subduction zones. They are mainly caused by the friction between the subducting and the overlying plate. In an initial stage, called the loading stage, static friction prevents slip between the two plates. The continuing convergence between the plates causes vertical movements in the upper plate and increased stress levels at the interface between the plates. Once the accumulated stresses overcome friction, slip will occur at the interface between the plates, generating large earthquakes. Large portions of the contact between the two plates will fail, releasing the huge amount of energy associated with earthquakes in subduction zone. As a result of slip, the upper plate will rebound, moving upward at rates of meters per second. One of the most destructive consequences of earthquakes are tsunamis, which are generated by the sudden upward movement of fault blocks. Huge water masses are suddenly displaced, generating waves which travel at velocities of hundreds of kilometers per hour over huge distances. In the case of a major earthquake in Alaska, the tsunami waves reached the coast of Australia 15 hours after the event. The third major feature associated with subduction zones are accretionary wedges. Because of the friction between the subducting and the upper plate, sediments and other rocks of the lower plate are scraped off and accreted to the upper plate. Not surprisingly, rocks in the accretionary wedges are highly deformed, and they form the initial stages of mountain building. Subduction zones in the world all share the three features mentioned above. Some other features are, however, different and have led to the definition of two end-member, Andean type and Pacific type subduction zones. The main difference between the two is the position of the subducting plate, which is gently deep in Andean type subductions and steep in Pacific type. A second difference between the two types of subduction zone is observed in the upper plate. The upper plate in Andean type is continuous and above sea level. Upper plate of Pacific type subduction, on the contrary, typically displays a marine basin. This basin is associated with extensional faults. The last issue I want to mention is that of the evolution through time of subduction zones. Some subduction zones continue for a long time without major changes. This is the case of Japan, where the Pacific Oceanic Plate has been subducting underneath Eastern Asia during the last 200 million of years. In other cases, when the oceanic crust laterally passes to continental crust. The two continents approach each other. When the continental crust arrives into the subduction zone, the lower and the upper plates have similar densities, and smooth subduction becomes difficult. Continental collision occurs, leading to the formation of the large mountain belts of the world.